To use physically based textures or PBR textures, first of all, make sure that you have Node Wrangler enabled. To do so, go to Add-ons, type Node, and then check the Node Wrangler box. Next, you'll need some PBR textures. Polyhaven.com is a great source for free textures. Go to Assets and then click on Textures, and then search for some texture that you like. I like this Castle Brick 02 red texture, so I'll click on that. You can choose a texture resolution. I think 4K is enough in this case. Then here, if you click on Zip, you can choose all of the files that you want. For example, you can choose to download a blend file, which already has the assembled material in it. And you can uncheck the things that you don't need. For example, I don't want a GLTF file. And then you can choose which files you want, as well as which file type. So for example, for diffuse, which is just color, a JPEG is more than enough. But for the displacement, I would prefer to have an EXR file because it's smaller than a PNG file. And it contains all the information that we need. For the normal maps, you have the choice between DirectX or OpenGL. I'll just uncheck the option of DirectX because Blender uses OpenGL. And then I will click on Download. Once I've downloaded and unzipped the downloaded file, we have the blend file, which actually already contains the assembled material, as well as a folder with all of the different textures. And you can see that the type of texture is identified in the file name. For example, NOR for normal map. Now in Blender, let's open a window for the shader editor and choose shader editor here. And then let's add an object to test the texture. So I'll choose a UV sphere. Let's scroll the mouse wheel to get a bit closer and I will set it to shade smooth. And I will add some subdivisions by increasing this to 2 levels. Now I can add a new material here or by clicking on new here. And since we already have the shader editor open, I'll just click on new here. Next, to add our downloaded PBR textures to this material, I simply click and select this principled BSDF node. And then I'll press Shift, Control and T. And then it will open this dialog. Then I can select all of these textures and click on Principled Texture Setup. And as you can see, it has created all of the nodes that we need. So it has the mapping nodes here and all of the textures. The only thing it has not connected is the ambient occlusion node. And in a moment, we will look at how to connect that. First of all, let's have a look at how we can see our texture. Now we are in solid mode, but if we click here, then we are in textured preview. And I'm also going to select cycles for the render engine. And I'm going to choose my GPU and turn on denoise to make it all a bit faster. If you don't have GPU, go to System in Preferences and make sure that the GPU is enabled here. Now it's a bit dark, so I will go to the World tab and I can either increase the strength of the world. And I have this HDRI checkbox. And if I check this, it will add an HDRI. And I have this option because I have the add-on Gather installed. And that's also free and it's also from the makers of Polyhaven. So as you can see, we have the texture. However, we don't have any displacement. It's still a perfectly smooth sphere. And now to get the displacement, make sure that you have your object selected so you can go into the Material tab. And then you might think it's somewhere here in Displacement, but it's not. That would make way too much sense. So go to Settings and then set Displacement here to Displacement only. And you can see that we need to change the scale. So here in the Displacement node, zoom in on it by scrolling the mouse wheel up, you can set the scale to something like 0.1. And as you can see, now we do have some real displacement. If you're wondering if you should use displacement only or displacement and bump, displacement and bump gets a little bit more detail out of the texture at a lower subdivision level. However, it takes a little bit longer to render. So that's up to you. And I will just choose an interesting HDRI to get a good look at the texture. And if you don't want to have the background of the HDRI, you can go to the render tab and then under Film, you can check the Transparent box. Now, if you want to mix in this Ambient Occlusion node, which looks like this, you can preview nodes by Shift and Control, left-clicking on it. So we can Shift, Control, left-click on each of these textures to see what they look like. And the Ambient Occlusion node just adds some kind of shadow in the texture as well. So I'll Shift, Control, and left-click on the Principled BSDF node again, so we can see its output. And so what we can do is we can add a Mix node, so either Shift A and then Search or Mix, or click here and go to Add, Converter, Mix, and then set this to Color, and set this to Multiply, because we're going to multiply these two textures, and then drag the color here to slot A, and the AO to slot B, and then the result can go back into the base color. And so now when I drag this vector to 0, we are just seeing the texture the way it was before, so I can show you the difference. So if I just drag the base color directly into here, we see the same result as if we have the factor of 0 with this mix. And when I drag the factor to 1, Then we mix in this AO. So you can see the difference when I add it and when I remove it. So the AO or ambient occlusion just adds a bit more shadow to it. And you don't have to keep this at one. It can also just be a more subtle effect. And so that's how we set up the PBR textures. Now, if I want to have a little bit more detail out of this, I can add a camera. So Shift A and choose camera. And then to make the camera look at this, I'll press Control, Alt, and 0. And that just gives the camera the view that we have in the viewport. And then in the option panel here, if I go to View, I can choose Lock Camera to View. So enable this and press N again to close that. And now we can rotate the view in the camera view and zoom in and out, just like we would with the 3D viewport. And when you're happy with that, you can unlock it. So we can just zoom in and out on that camera view. Now let's have a look at how we can squeeze a bit more detail out of that texture. So instead of a shader editor, I'm going to add an image editor and scroll up to zoom in a bit. And let's render this. So go to Render, Render Image, or press F12. And the reason it's showing the render output in my image editor window here and not in some pop-up window is because in Preferences under Interface, I've set Temporary Editors Render In to Image Editor. So you can choose here if you want to open that in a new window or in the image editor. And I just prefer to keep it in the interface of Blender rather than constantly having pop-up windows. So this is the result of the render with just two levels of subdivisions. And if I increase the subdivisions here, then we will get more detail out of our texture. But another thing I can do, because I'm using a camera, I can go here and I can choose the experimental feature set. And then in the subdiv modifier, I can check adaptive subdivision. And what that does is it will add more resolution to where the camera is close to the object, and it will use less resolution for where it is far away. And so you can see the result when I render this. And so this is the result with a dicing scale of 1. And let me just open another slot for another render, and we can compare them more easily. And so the dicing scale, I will set it to 5, for example, and render again. So this is the result of a dicing scale of 5. And you can see when I compared to the previous render that it is much lower resolution. So when you increase this number, you reduce the resolution. So the lower this number, the higher the resolution and the higher the detail on your object will be. But of course, at the cost of longer render time. And in some cases, if you set it too low, then it might run out of memory as well. So what if you want to use EV instead of cycles? Well, good news, it's very easy. As of Blender 4.2, you just have to switch to EV, and that's all. As you can see, you now have displacement in EV as well. Now, if you want this material to look smaller or bigger, you can go to the mapping node and then click and drag down on these scale values. So you select all of them, and then you can just add a higher value, like 3, for example, and that scales the texture down. And now it's very obvious that we need to increase the levels of the resolution a bit. Just make sure that the levels of the render are also set higher, otherwise your render will turn out lower resolution than your viewport. One more thing you might be wondering is, what if you want to make this real geometry? Now you can see that this mesh is still very simple, and what if I want to have all this real displacement as geometry? Well, it's not enough to just apply the subdiv modifier, because as you can see, it's still perfectly smooth and round. Let's undo that. Well, the way you can do that is to select the displacement texture and the displacement node and either mute them by pressing M or just delete them by pressing X. And then you can add a displace modifier and then click on New and then click on this icon to go to the texture tab and then select the displacement texture from your downloaded PBR set. And it usually has DISP in the file name. And of course, now it looks very strange. So as the coordinates, use UV and choose the UV map. And then reduce the strength to something like 0.1 again. And as you can see, now we have the displacement back. Now you might notice that it doesn't really look right. And that's because we had the scale of the material set to 3. But the displacement still has the scale of 1. So here in the displacement texture, click on this icon. And then in the texture tab under mapping, set this to the same value that you have here. So in this case, 3. And as you can see, now it looks more like the way it should. And then select your object by clicking on it. Control A. And choose Visual Geometry to Mesh. And that just applies all the modifiers. And as you can see, now we have all of this as geometry. Now, what if your object simply doesn't have a UV map? So this is a UV sphere, which comes with a UV map by default. But let's just delete it. And in that case, it doesn't know how to map the textures. But what we can do is we can just use generated texture coordinates. So drag the generated into the vector here. And then in the textures, instead of flat, use box. So set it to box for all of these textures. And then we can use a blend value of something like 0.2. And that just blends the projection in every way. So it doesn't work perfectly with this kind of brick texture, but it's better than nothing. And this is called triplanar or box mapping. And it just kind of projects the texture from three axes. But as you can see, that also makes it kind of blend here and there, which is not ideal. But if you have no UVs, then it's better than nothing. But of course, a better solution if you don't have a UV map is just to UV unwrap it so you do have a UV map. So I hope that answered all of your questions about setting up PBR textures in Blender for Cycles and Eevee. If you still have some questions about this, please leave a comment. And thanks for watching all the way to the end.